bed and I stumble to the kitchen. Pour myself a cup of ambition and yawn and stretch and try to come to life. Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the streets the traffic starts jumping, with folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taking and no giving.
Good morning, Wake Up Wildcats. I'm Seth Ankeny. Today is Monday, March 21st, and it is Nay Day. Today it will be sunny, with a low of 43 and a high of 70 degrees. Tomorrow's weather is going to be partly cloudy, so make sure to get outside. The cafeteria will be serving chicken fillet and a whole wheat bun, regular or spicy, or mini twin cheeseburger. Tomorrow we'll be having chicken Alfredo and French bread pizza. PB&J is offered daily. Starting tomorrow, there will be buses available at 4:45 to take students home if they are staying after with the teacher on Tuesday or Thursday. Students will not be able to get on the bus without a pass. Don't forget, Makeup Center and tutoring are available weekly, Tuesdays and Thursdays. This is a great opportunity for students to get that extra help needed in all subjects for no cost. Let's talk theater. Save the date. The Great British Drama Department brings you Romeo and Juliet Apocalypse, April 21 through April 23. Make sure to keep an ear out for more information. Are you interested in farming or gardening? Want to learn more about growing fruits and vegetables? Looking for a worthwhile cause to volunteer your time? Did you know that Great Bridge has a production garden and small orchard? Last year alone, we donated over 300 pounds of fresh vegetables and fruit that went to food banks and organizations right here in Chesapeake to serve people in our city who suffer from food insecurities. If you're interested in hearing the story of the Wildcat Farm and helping out, stop in room 201 for an informational meeting on Wednesday, March 23rd. Right after school. If you can't stay after school, stop in room 201 sometime that day. Our look into women history starts off this week with Margaret Brent. Brent was born around the 1600s in England. She was known to be North America's first feminist. She grew to become one of the largest landowners in Maryland, yet she was the first woman in the English North America colonies to appear before a court of common law. She was a significant foundling settler in the early histories of the colonies Maryland and Virginia. She is most famous for her role she played in Maryland politics between 1644 and 1649. She died around 1671, and people still look up to her till this day. For sports, our tennis team goes head-to-head with Jamestown at home. Boys play tonight and girls tomorrow. Varsity softball is also at home against War Hill. JV and varsity baseball will take on Nansman River. Varsity is away and JV is at home. Tomorrow, our soccer team takes the field. JV will play Grassfield, while our varsity girls and boys will play Grafton at home. I'm Seth Ankeny. Wake up, Wildcats, and make it a great day.